Now, to carry on our inspirational stories, we are joined by co-founder and CEO of KidsCan, Julie Chapman, who has, since launching the charitable trust in 2005, provided, get this, more than 277,000 raincoats, 128,000 pairs of shoes, 19 million food items to New Zealand children in 675 low-decile schools. So let's welcome Julie to the Harvey Norman Lounge.
Yes!
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Angel.
It is absolutely phenomenal. So let me get this straight. You started all of that back in your garage in 2005.
Yes. Look, I really have a passion for education, and I believe that education equals opportunity. And when I found out that literally thousands of kids were going without the basics that I took for granted growing up, food, clothing, shoes, basic health and hygiene items, I decided I really wanted to do something about it. So set up in the garage all those years ago, kind of a one-man band really, and yeah, just got things happening.
So you started ringing around companies saying, "Hi, this is Julie, I'm starting this thing, I want to give raincoats to the school."
Yeah, so I guess one of the companies that we first approached was Perpetual Guardian, and I managed to convince them to donate $40,000, which kind of got us off the ground. And then it really was a case of, you know, getting out there, knocking on doors. Lots of people said no, because poverty wasn't something that was sort of top of mind for people, I guess, in New Zealand, and it was
but we don't
quite
have poverty
shocking.
In New Zealand?
I know, apparently not. But it was shocking to people that this could be happening in our own backyard. But slowly, surely, and with lots of tenacity, I managed to wear people down. It probably gave me stuff to make me go away, but that's okay. It
worked.
Yeah. 12 years later, we're in 675 schools with over 160,000 children having access to those things that we provide.
And that's incredible, you know, right out the back of your garage, I guess, real grassroots Kiwi charity. I just wanted to know, though, what was the trigger? Did you read something? Did you see a news item? Were you researching? What was the trigger?
Oh, it was a few things. So it was wanting to work in an organisation that did something really tangible. It was talking to teachers. It was reading media reports. You know, back to school was always the time when those kind of reports roll out. Kids are going without this, they're going without that. And so I really just felt inspired to kind of find out what the issues were and how big they were. And, you know, we did a really unsophisticated survey of 80 low-decile schools, right. And it kind of blew me away how big the problem was. So
when you started it, you approached the schools? I mean, they obviously come to you now. What was it like, that initial feedback?
I think they were quite, so the need was there, we knew the need was there, but schools are used to having to jump through a lot of hoops and a lot of bureaucracy, so they couldn't really understand that we were going to offer them something that didn't have a whole lot of strings attached. And of course we want them to be accountable for the things we give them, but you know, so it's really about building those relationships and that trust level, and we've managed to do that, which is great.
And what does it mean to, you know, to, I guess, give to these kids? What does it do for them?
So I guess if you think about what life is like for a child that doesn't have the basics, doesn't have access to three meals a day, it's a real grind. It's not the kind of poverty, I guess, that we see overseas in third world countries, but it is real. And for the children that we support, it means they get sick more often, they have less opportunity to reach their potential at school, they miss a lot of school. And so giving them these things just removes those barriers to education and actually just makes them feel like they're normal kids, part of, you know, everyday kind of school.
Well, if they're not eating properly, then they're not going to be learning properly, are they? Because you really need to nourish the brain.
Well, exactly. And I mean, you know, food insecurity is a big issue. We're feeding more than 26,000 children a week across New Zealand now. And I mean, you know what it's like if you don't eat for a long period of time.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And, you know, for kids, it's vital that they have that nutrition, and they perform better at school. They're able to learn better if they're happy, healthy, and not hungry.
So you have the raincoats, the shoes, the food. Are there other things that you supply?
Yeah, so we provide a range of sort of health and hygiene type items, so toothbrushes, toothpaste, plasters, tissues, hand sanitizer, and in more recent times, over the past 2 years, feminine hygiene products, because we know that that is a big issue for girls who will stay home from school, and those things which shouldn't be are becoming luxury items.
Mm. Gosh, it's ridiculous, isn't it?
What would you put the success down to, do you think, of KidsCan? Because honestly, it's been a hugely successful charity. Is it because of the need, or is it just because of the willingness for people to help? What is it?
I think it's a bit of both. I think it's definitely not being afraid to ask for help and to tell people about the issue. But, you know, I just love the relationships that we've built. I just get to work with the most incredible people every day, and people that really care about kids in New Zealand. Mm. And I think people want to be part of that solution, and giving them something practical they can do is really important.
I absolutely, totally agree.
Yeah.
Well, that's great. From Brilliant. The garage, obviously a lot bigger than the garage right
now.
Thank you so much, Julie.
Pleasure.
For more on KidsCan and how you can help, you can go to kidscan.org.nz right now.